my mother never gave her child, never let on. And my mother never let the fact that she had eight children be an excuse for lowering her exacting standards. And when we were little, many of us all knew about how impeccably dressed we were and in the latest style. Who can forget Melissa, age 5, with pink pants and a white pillow? At Easter time, my mom would prepare 3 or 4 baskets for each of us and hide them in ingenious places throughout the house. And although we always had a clothes dryer, our mother would hang load after load on the line because she thought clothes were hung out to dry, smelled better. And then there was the irony. And having 8 children never stopped our mother from entertaining from many friends. You get some idea of all the coordination involved in hosting a party with 8 kids and a letter from my Grandma Niffin to my Aunt Judy from 1965. Her grandma writes, Kathy and Judy came over and stayed all night, 2 less at home. Then both Dick and Mary babysat. Chuck thinks he should start, but mother tells him he falls asleep too easily. Anyway, she needed him home to help with cooking, etc. They all had baths early, the 2 small boys ready for bed. My mother was a true Sagittarius, and no matter how many family members we had at a holiday event, and that was usually a lot, she loved it when her friends stopped by or we brought our friends over. I remember when a friend of Mary Ellen and Kevin came to our Christmas Eve party dressed as Santa Claus for the first time. The grandchildren were petrified, and when he asked them to sit on his lap, they just stood there frozen. So our mom, never missing a beat, went over and was the first to sit on Santa's lap. This became something of a Christmas tradition. When she hosted her bridge or pinochle club, we would sit on the landing of the staircase and just wait for the explosions of laughter. Blessed with a house full of children and a loving husband, our mom felt especially enormous compassion for people who lived alone. She took our neighbor, Mrs. Butler, to her doctor's appointments and to do her shopping, and she made sure that we shoveled her drive when it snowed and that we refused to take any money for it. She regularly invited my dad's aunts, Pearl and Ruth, to dinner, as well as her own widow, Aunt Lee. And she would often take my grandma Bear to our various school events. I remember when I was in grade school here at St. Paul's, I participated in a speech contest at Canisius High School. It was an all-day event, and in the afternoon, my mother came to the award ceremony and brought my grandma Bear. I was very annoyed because I thought I couldn't win anything and that she'd drag grandma here for nothing and it would all be very embarrassing. Well, when in the end I won the contest, I was of course very glad Grandma Bear was there. My mother's charity was quiet. She didn't think she was doing anything special. It's just what she did. I could of course go on and on about our mother when she was in her prime and the fullness of health. But I want also to recognize today the grace and dignity with which our mother faced the many health challenges of the last 10 years. Displaying what the Russian Orthodox call spleenia, or acceptance of suffering, she never became embittered, resentful, or angry. To the contrary, and so while so many things were taken away from her during this time, something core and essential remained to the end. My mother's kindness, her innate sociability, and her sense of humor, which made her a favorite of the staff and all the facilities that she was caring for. After a lifetime of caring for others, she allowed herself to be taken care of. And Melissa, Willie, and I are so grateful to our brothers and sisters here in Buffalo who did such an amazing job of that. A few years ago, my sister Mary arranged for the anointing of the sick for my mom. We weren't sure at the time that she'd understand anything, but when the priest finished reciting the prayer, which ended, expel all afflictions of mind and body, mercifully restore her to full health, and enable to preserve her former duties, there was a short pause, and then my mother said, I'm looking forward to it. My mom turned up could have been a very somber event into something joyful. At her 80th birthday party, I spoke about my mom's natural teacherly instincts, how she would quiz me on spelling words or multiplication tables while I was getting ready for school, never making me feel bad for missing an answer, always making it into a game, deftly inserting the problem word back into the list until I got it right. Over these last 10 years, my mother's taught me much bigger lessons about life. And I know I speak for all my brothers and sisters when I say how proud